Which of these would you guess is the fastest sport? If you said baseball, soccer, or even tennis, you'll have to give it another shot. And no, it's not pickleball either.
Considering the speed of the shuttlecock at the release after being hit, it can reach up to over 200 miles per hour.
Yes, badminton. The sport many Americans play outdoors casually in their backyard is one of the world's fastest sports. To understand why this seemingly simple sport holds the title for world's fastest racket sport, we have to head indoors.
The weather and the temperature could actually cause the shuttlecock to fly in different way than expected.
Indoors, players smash, clear, drop, and drive the shuttlecock towards their opponent. It's a sport with roots in ancient Greece, China, Japan, and India, but its current regulations were developed in England and brought to the United States in the 19th century, where the first badminton club opened in New York in 1878. The rules have changed over time, but the one constant is the shuttlecock.
This is a kind of a unique shape for a projectile. Comparing to other sports, it's a cone shape and there are 16 feathers made of a goose.
Only 4 feathers per bird make the cut for the optimal and uniform curvature, shape, and weight. No matter how the shuttlecock is hit, it will fly nose first.
All other ball sports created the ball to make it fly faster. The shuttlecock is made actually to slow down after being hit.
The feathers create drag, which leads to a more predictable flight path, giving the player more control over shots.
Surprisingly, 80% of the speed can be preserved.
As the shuttlecock descends, the flight angle becomes more steep than its lift, a unique property for a projectile in sports. The feathers break easily, which can make the shuttlecock wobble during flight. Several are often used in one match. And players can even alter the speed of the shuttle with some minor adjustments to the feathers.
If I want to increase the speed of the flying, I will tip the end of the feather inside so less air resistance actually can be encountered during flight.
Just don't try that during a match. It's cheating. And Dr. Chinarthur Chu would know. In addition to his work in kinesiology or the study of human movement, Dr. Chu is a national-level badminton umpire and a top player trained in China. Dr. Chu and his team wanted to understand how players could transfer the most speed to the shuttlecock. He looked at racket angle, swing speed, and string tension when players hit a smash.
We suspended the shuttlecock from the ceiling, put the reflective markers on the head of the shuttlecock and the racket head so that we can keep track of the shuttlecock movement after impact to see how fast the shuttlecock was moving and in which angle it was moving so that we can correlate it to their swinging performance.
Dr. Chu and his team found that the fastest shuttlecock speed was achieved by expert players when the racket angle was 71.6 degrees. Recreational players could swing the racket just as fast as expert players, but since they weren't able to hit the shuttlecock at that optimal angle, they weren't able to achieve the highest speed. It's really hard to get that angle right because
it's a complicated process. You have to bend your knees to lower down your weight so that you can jump. Then the energy is going to be passed from the lower body to the upper body, to the shoulder, to the elbow, to the wrist, and eventually to the finger. And all those energy is going to be added up, passed through the racket to the shuttlecock.
There you have it. From lightning fast shuttlecocks to split second reflexes, it's clear why badminton is the fastest racket sport. Think you're up for the challenge? Why not grab your racket and see for yourself? Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more science and badminton videos.